So now we talk about which is the state of the art or the most commonly used program for doing heuristic sequence alignment sequence searches. The original version of GLAS plus one was developed in 1990 by Carlin et al. And it only performed ungapped alignments, which is not very useful. So although it was fast, significantly faster than FastA, it didn't produce. It wasn't useful for searching for homologs because we only could find very, very close homologs. However, since BLAS 2, which was developed a few years later, it can also make gapped alignments. And this has made it actually more sense than BLAST, than FastA, and also faster. And a few reasons for this is that it actually, the main reason is that it has used a much more advanced underlying statistical model for evaluating similarities between alignments or significance of alignments. So basically, asking if you have aligning something to something else, is this purely by chance or is this something that has been selected for? So does it infer homology? So by doing that, the idea is similar. You use some kind of heuristic search algorithm first to find diagonals in the alignment matrix that are that is similar. But in contrast to FastA, it does not only use identity matches. It also uses almost similar sequences, identical sequences, sequences that differ slightly. And then use some other technical differences, like using finite state out of matter. So in principle, the idea is similar as has been proposed in FastA. You want to make a dot plot, so dot plot. But you don't do that by finding only single sequence, but you find words that are similar to the starting sequence. You basically make a dot plot. And here you can see that actually in BLAST, you don't use pairs of sequences. You sequence one query sequence against the database. So step one is to make the database dot plot. Step two is to look up all the words that you want to find. And step three is to extend this word. And step four is to make a gapped alignment in these three areas. It's very similar to FastA. However, there are a number of differences. And as I said, the main thing is that it uses statistical evaluation. But the whole idea here is that also that it uses that homologous sequences are likely to contain not only identical regions, but at least short high scoring pairs of words, pairs of regions of sequences, which we call a hit. And then you will try to extend it later to get optimal sequence alignments. So the idea is that you want to find all significant hits. So if you have a query word length of three, which is common, so relate to k equals 3 in FastA, you will take not only in this case p, q, g, but you will also take sequences of three amino acids that are similar enough to give a score in the Blossom matrix or default matrix, which is higher than the cutoff, in this case 13. So PQG will give 18, PEG 15, and PDG and PHG, so they will give 30. So you will find all these matches that end of these sequences, but you will not find PQA because you have score 12. If you remember the Blossom 62 matrix, take a break, look it up from the early studies now. Here you see, so what is the highest score that you can find for an identity matrix? So it's three or four. And actually that means that even there's alanine, so polyadenine, so it's alanine, three alanines, would not even give a score higher than 13 for an identity max. So you will ignore that. And the reason is of course because alanine is quite common and it's not that well conserved. But anyway, so basically this is just, you would find more hits with using this than you would using only the identity matrices. So you have more diagonals to do it. And then the second step is exactly, so step one, You won't find it in neighborhood. So this is very identical in a false thing. And then the difference in mistake two, that was in false state, you were trying to find take top 10 diagonals. Here you take all significant diagonals. So basically you try to extend them. First step, well, step two is actually to scan the database. First one was to calculate them. First step two is to identify all the diagonals and make these dot plots. So you do this by using hash table. So you basically can do this very fast, exactly as we did in false state. So you find, if you have the LAA, you find also AAL. And you know the AAL is fine in position 2, 3, 10, 10, 11, etc. Exactly as in false state. So, and then you want to extend. So step three is actually to extend the gaps. You basically just take the same diagonal, no gaps, and just extend it until the score drops below a certain cutoff. So this hit now, which can be a length three or longer, or depends on what cutoffs use, but it can be longer. It's called a high scoring segment pair, or and hit word, you can call it. And these hit words, you can actually do a statistical relation. So we come back to this, what you have is basically an E value, so the expected number of hits you will find at these cutoffs, but in a random set of sequences. So this is the expected number to occur only by chance. Principally, a small E value means that it's very unlikely to find it by chance, and high, that it's likely to find it by chance. So if you have a 10 to minus 20 E value, that would never ever, or only 10 to 20 examples occur by chance. But if you have an E value of 0.1, if you run it 10 times, you would get one score. On average, you get one hit then every 10th time. So you take this, you have a cutoff here, and you include all the hits that are below a certain cutoff, E values. And the E values is calculated using this formula, which is depending on the kappa constant, that are the K and S and lambda are dependent on the matrix and also the composition biases. But then you have the length of the query and the length of the database. So it means that if you have a big database, you will need to have a better score to have to find to get the same E value. So the E value increase if you have a big database and the same score. Sometimes we talk about p-value, which is basically the same thing, but they're easily converging using the formula below here for that. And this we'll talk more about later. So here was an example, and in this tape, it was like 5 times faster on Blas and false day, and both these algorithms are 20 or 100 times faster than dynamic programming. So in general, you would say that dynamic programming would give the most sensitive results. But because it uses all information of two sequences, but the running time is slow because most of the time is spent calculating the useless area of computing the optimal alignment. So you calculate, particularly if you start a database. So if you think about it, in a database, you want to find the homologous pairs, but most of the sequences in the database are not related to your query sequence, and therefore, you will spend time still figuring out this matrix, calculating it. It's not related. So if you can ignore that area, you're going to do much faster. Faster is less sensitive, clearly, than dynamic programming, and also than BLAST. But it's much faster than dynamic programming because it speeds up things. And BLAST is actually more sensitive than fast day, and comparatively almost as sensitive as dynamic programming, because it has a much better statistical model to evaluate the results. And it's actually faster than the faster, because it, in particular because you have pre-approaching the databases, and use also this, you can use the longer keyword, for instance, you can do, find fewer hits beginning, and the more hits are more statistically relevant. So this is one thing in FAST, in principle you do, you search a database, just basic number of sequences, you search among one. In BLAST, the database is all sequences together, and you do a query calculating all of them. And you pre-processing the data. So this is what you do in the lab later. There are actually several different programs on BLAST that are run in different versions, and particularly basically you can run nucleotide sequences or protein sequences, but you can also do conversion between them. So you can even run T BLAST X, which compares the six-fold translation of a nuclear sequence to a six-fold translation of another nuclear sequence using the pre-proven matches. So why would you do that? So do you think the reason is because the protein sequences are much easier to conserve? So you get you're much better to take a homology between proteins and between nucleotides. Nuclei is fine if you have 50% identity nuclear level, but when you go down to 20% sequence identity level on amino acids level, it's very hard to get good alignments on the nucleotide level alone. So, but and BLAS has different versions of it. So that's what we also try to do later. Thank you, and